Well, everyone has said they've had a wonderful week here in Fort McMurray. We are at the Suncor Community Leisure Center. This is the Canadian Natural Resources Arena. Let's meet the two teams now. It's brought to you by Ford, proud partner of the Canadian Curling Association for 19 years. They are the youngest team here out of the Kamloops Curling Club. 17-year-old Corryn Brown is her skip. All the players are 17. Sidney Fraser, Sam Fisher, and Aaron Pincott finished at 9-1. The Manitoba champions out of the St. Vital Curling Club in Winnipeg, skipped by 18-year-old Shannon Birchard. Mariah Mondor was with her a year ago, winning the silver medal. Shayna Andres and Nicole Sigvaldason are the new members of these Manitoba champions. Both teams finished with 9-1 records. BC, though, by virtue of that win in round robin, they had the choice of hammer or stones. They've elected to take the last rock. Manitoba will play the yellow stones. BC does have the hammer here in the first, and to get us underway, it is the women's final of the M&M Juniors. And this is Mariah Mondor. I thought what was, in listening to those comments, Russ, from the coaches, and in particular Ken Brown, who coaches the BC team, he said, they know Manitoba, this is the final. We know this is the final, but the Rocks, they don't know that it's a final. I like the psychology.
Absolutely. That's so wonderful. I remember growing up and trying to beat the Ed Wernicks and the Paul Savages that were our idols. And it's exactly what my dad said to me. They only get to throw two each, eight a team, and it's whoever plays best today in this big game. And we're in for a good one because they're, you know, 9-1, both teams. The only blemish to Manitoba was to BC, but that was actually a blowout. So it's going to be interesting how Manitoba approaches this.
Let's take a look at what you think these two teams just may do.
Well, I think British Columbia has played a lot more draw shots, a lot softer shots. I just saw a take with their very soft weight. That's their way to play. So play with some confidence. Get some rocks to play. I know you're all rookies, but let's put some pressure on the other team. That's the only way you're going to win. For Manitoba, look at that shot Shannon played this morning against Ontario. The big weight ability, just like that other team from Manitoba we watched yesterday. Yeah. So get the rocks and the rings and make it a hitting contest.
The game plan brought to you by World Financial Group, helping families have better financial futures.
Fairly standard opening here with BC having hammer, that first stone slipping right to the back. Mariah's, you could easily have thrown up a corner guard, but most teams in such an important game, the national final here, it's not wrong to hit it and kind of catch your breath here and get used to the rocks and the ice before you really make a move.
Okay, tight's fine. Tight's not bad, guys.
Now, yesterday we did see, and you pointed out, that the ice was very, very quick.
Yeah, it is. It's fantastic. Jamie Sage and his crew have done an amazing job out here, Vic. It's not quite as much curl as you'd have for like a briar, but that's good because a lot of these teams wouldn't be used to that type of finish. You throw the right weight, it'll bury either way, inside out, outside in. And the percentages have shown it. There's some good numbers out there this week, male and female.
Peel, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Shayna Andres, she is one of the new members of the team.
Just a piece of it, but that's all you need with these rocks. These are brand new curling stones from the CCA, and the hitting bands are absolutely rounded still. They're not worn flat or actually indented a little bit. And the action they're getting in these rocks is absolutely incredible. There's a good, you see how white it is around that running edge because they haven't been bruised yet. They're actually brand new, and it's a lot like a different type of golf ball where some golf balls will spin more. These have so much action. It took the curlers three or four games to get used to them.
Didn't you say these are going on to the Briar,
the teams at the Briar, I'll tell you, they are going to love these. The big weight ability of some of those teams, there'll be rocks flying all over the place.
Nine. Nine, five. Okay. You got it. Let's go.
We mentioned yesterday that
9-5, 8-5.
You see on resumes now, Canada Winter Games, for example, four, and four, a lot of CIS four. Play. Shana plays for the University of Manitoba Bisons in university curling.
The university curling seems to be really growing, and there's a lot of the top juniors are migrating to that also, and it's just more experience for these young players.
And there's even a college now,
right?
College level as well.
Clean.
Well, Sam Fisher, you know, for example, here just throwing cheese. She played in the 2011 Canada Winter Games for BC. So it's 10-end games, as you know, 40 minutes thinking time if you're just joining us for the first time this season. It's been changed, no longer the running of the stone. It's the time you take to make a shot, two timeouts, and 90 seconds in total. So it's 90 seconds for that coach to get up and get down to the ice.
Nine.
No longer just waiting until the coach gets there before starting the clock.
Yeah, it's a good rule. The coaches get there earlier, keeps the game moving, and that's what it's all about. 60 seconds is plenty of time to get your opinion across. See, a little bit different, just like the Manitoba game yesterday, where the Manitoba teams throw a little bit more weight. Not that that's wrong, but BC throws very soft takeout weight here. They're calling for control. I love that, because you got to hang around on some of these. This situation doesn't matter as much, but once there's rocks in play, you've got to be able to control that thrown rock. That's a great example of the weight control there. That only hit a good solid half, but it hangs around.
So an early mistake, Nicole Sigvaldason.
3-7, I think.
That's a sharp rock.
Sharp rock, that's interesting, because they have the choice of any yellow in the building.
I don't want that.
They're now saying they don't want it.
Now, just about that shot, because quite often Linda make the point, and Linda will be with us again when join you next weekend for the Scotties in Kingston, Ontario.
Right off.
That she played that takeout, Sigvaldason, outside in.
Right.
Many times, the better shot is the inside out, right?
Well, one of the best teams in the country, Jennifer Jones, will do that all the time. They do play inside out. It's just a habit. I always played outside in. It's the shot you're going to have to throw to get to the button, so you like to throw that shot. But either way works. But in this case, there's so many factors. It's the speed, where the broom was, how much rotation, did you get it started, is it the rock? And in a lot of cases, in the first end, it could be the pebble. And a little bit of fresh pebble. They're saying that rock might be a little sharper. That combination with the sharper stone will allow it to bend more. And a chance for two here.
Skip stones. Can you roll it over and lay it on the corner if you're Manitoba, or is it too steep?
I don't think you can throw it quite that hard. I think the prudent play would be to hang around here.
Nine.
Hope for a mistake out of the other team.
Whoa! Yeah, whoa! Whoa!
Whoa!
Clean.
Roll
clean it.
Roll it right over. Go.
That's a great shot, Vic. Now there is an angle. When this is hit dead on, there will be a better angle. Well, coach team, and a few years ago, you'd see teams throw it a billion miles an hour trying to jump it across and make that double. When they miss it, the other team would split the house, and the opportunity for the two would not be there.
It is Bruce Birchard who is coaching the Manitoba champions out of the St. Patel. This BC team hasn't been on the ice. They've practiced, certainly, but they haven't played since round robin was finished on Thursday. They played a couple of tiebreakers Friday.
Yep.
That's in the semis there went earlier today. Corryn Brown.
Gotta go.
Big brush here trying to not hand back the chance, and she just did.
That's why it was so important for Shannon to hang around. Don't be the hero on the first one, then that changes the entire end around.
You know, and we point out again, and the we know last year the problems that Shannon Birchard had with nerves, and it's so fragile if you don't get off to a good start. The confidence goes. So this is a great opportunity for her to, when she saw maybe a two going up on the board.
Yes.
There's a Corryn Brown handing it right back.
Oh, the Manitoba walk out of here really happy. Now you've got that opportunity. This is one of the ones, fresh pebble, first in. You certainly do not want to miss this wide. There's quite a few times the skip that's trying to blank here will hit this dead on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got it.
See, that's not hair again.
It's that hair. You got it.
Final stone, looking for the blank. Picked up by Fisher and Fraser. And enough to get it out the side, they do. So a blank goes on the board. BC thought they might have two in their pocket. They are the junior men's champions from the West Kildonan Curling Club in Winnipeg, skipped by Matt Dunstone, winning yesterday 4-3 over Alberta and the team from the Saville Sports Center, and skipped by Thomas Scoffin. Prior to the draw today, all the teams, 14 women, 14 men, largest event the CCA puts on. This year, of course, all 10 provinces plus Northern Ontario, as well as all the territories, Yukon, Northwest, and for the first time, Nunavut. Congratulations to all who participated this week here in Fort McMurray. As we welcome you back, it's our final day, just our second day of coverage, weekend coverage of the M&M Meat Shops Canadian Juniors, of Lank in the first. Once again, BC will have the last rock. They have the hammer playing the red stones.
10-5.
Mariah Mondor has.
Whoa.
This is her third appearance at the juniors in 2010. She played with Brianne Meekin. They went 6-6 in Sorel, Quebec.
A little bit of nerves there. That was a little pushed outward motion. Again, Manitoba's throwing a little bit more weight, a little bit more chance to roll out. And then those shots don't look that drastic when there's nothing in play, but it's a chance to have a free corner guard thrown up there. And if the corner guard isn't continually peeled off, a shot for a come around and score their deuce. So that hit and roll out with these lively rocks, I think that's going to be the story of the day, is keep it in play.
Guys, just tee.
Okay, interesting, they called it in, Vic. And still trying to keep it close to the vest.
And look at how that, you would have thought that was going to stop.
Oh my goodness.
Top edge of the eight.
No kidding.
And it slides to the back.
It's quick. They're getting times.
Well, what would you say? It was interesting how you said it yesterday, because I hadn't heard it broken down like that before. You thought curling club is usually about 22 seconds?
Yes.
They're saying here 26, and you thought how many feet per second?
Like about 4 to 5, depending. It depends on the surface too. But
good one.
That's a significant difference to the leg drive, and More importantly, you can drag it farther than you can in most curling clubs. Some curling clubs have speed similar to this too, but the average curling club that I've played in lately, it would be a little bit slower, and that also makes a difference with the brushing, because you can probably drag it 2, maybe 3 feet farther on arena conditions. That makes the draw weight so much easier.
T! Higher if you can.
No more.
T. Oh. No. T. Higher if you can.
His entire BC team represented the province at the Winter Games in 2011, winning the gold medal. It was played in Halifax. They went 6-1. Again, it's another level of experience, as you say. That's when we talk about it all the time, getting out and experiencing all that curling has, whether it be the ice conditions, the building conditions, whatever it happens to be.
And that's what really helps when you're 17 like this. We're saying they're rookies, but in some ways they're not. The Canada Winter Games is just like going to an Olympic Games. Same type of event. You're there with your entire province, the hockey team, and all the different sports that are there. And it's you really feel a different type of pressure, and that's really going to help them in this game.
Be interesting to see when Corryn Brown decides to make the move here. They make mention again that they haven't played since Thursday. So you might think if they can get through this, you'd have to start something.
You'd think so, but on the other hand, tied coming home 0-0, you still have the hammer. And
don't say that.
So you might see Shannon make the move here first.
Okay, you got it.
375. They're saying they take out the three because it's the same for every draw. So 375. That's a wee bit slower than it was yesterday. Again, we're into a fairly fresh area. Pocket.
Sorry, Nick.
It's just that quick.
High five.
Maybe they gave the wrong number out there, Vic, because 375 would be through yesterday, and I think that spot's had enough rocks now. Just like that one back there. The brushers were happy when she let it go. It's just quick. We often see it. We cover so many games that inside-out shot seems to be the fastest.
Go if you have to. Lots of room, go if you can. Line's okay.
Line's good.
Really good line if this slows down.
Aaron Pincock. Cole Sigvaldason throwing the third stones. Avoid the jam at the back. Nicely done, and rolls the shooter over to sit now T-line, 12 foot, and there's jammable stuff there now.
Certainly a simple takeout, but if that rolls out, the freeze would probably be made better because they now know what that does for the BC team. So you could easily jam on the back. Shrapnel.
Let's go normal.
Okay, normal.
They're gonna change it up here the other turn. Should curl a little bit more.
Normal. Yeah, really hard.
Not a lot of weight here.
Really hard. Hard. Hard.
There is the jam, and it spills in to be shot stone. Remember now that BC does have last rock here in this second end.
That's fine, Aaron.
Sorry.
Good throw. Just touch tight if anything. Yeah. Nice weight.
Always close.
Yeah, no, for sure.
A little bit more finish in that spot. threw beautiful weight under pressure. You tend to overthrow, and she didn't overthrow at all. And that's what allowed it to curl.
Oh, the back one? Yeah, you should hit it in the left side.
Lots of room to roll, and you have to think of these shots. You can hit it dead on, but any mistake narrow, it's going to roll out for sure. So you've got lots of room on the right-hand side as we look at it.
Would you like to roll it as far away as possible?
I think it would, because chances are if you just roll an inch or two, it'd be a double. So, yeah, you'd like to roll it right across that center line if you could.
Skip Stones. Shannon Birchard. Andries Mondor. And out the side it goes. The raised rock jams at the back. And now is there a possible deuce setting up here for BC?
Certainly is, Vic.
I just threw it, so.
See what they say there. Shannon thinks she was a hair tight. It's two in a row that have overcurled in that spot. It's been a human error as opposed to not putting the broom in the right spot.
Normal or control?
Normal.
Normal? Okay.
Touch roll over your way.
Stick down. Around. Okay, you got it.
Let's go, guys.
You got it.
Third out turn in a row here. They should know the spot.
Yep.
A little more weight.
Yes! Real hard!
Fisher and Fraser pick her up right out of her hand. Another opportunity here for BC to possibly set themselves up for a couple, and she'll bang it right on the nose. Just couldn't hold it to roll it away.
Bubbles there.
At the end?
Yeah.
Half a rock, I'll be real close.
Comes up quite a bit there.
Pardon me?
Comes up quite a bit there.
There's the comment. The BC team talking about it afterwards. They made the shot, but then they analyzed it after, and I like to see that because that's how you remember spots. Even though she made it, they turned around and said, boy, that curled a lot in that spot. Two overcurled. Technically, that overcurled a hair.
Which would you prefer?
So they now have that nailed down.
Yeah. Okay.
Look at the ice taken here. That's a lot of ice for half a rock, so it must finish good.
Stone for Manitoba here in two.
Hard! Whoa, whoa! Yes!
It's close.
Bang it. One, two, and there they go. Well, both teams so far in two have made their mistakes, yet regrouped to get themselves out of trouble.
And it really was just ice reading. A couple overcurled, both teams figured it out, made the adjustment, and they're making shots. That's what's so great about the young teams now. You used to see a lot of it, and maybe not teams at this level, but you'd see a lot of teams that would never put the broom in the right spot for hours on end. You have to believe your eyes. There's a lot of curl there. They figured it out. Good throw there.
So final stone, Corryn Brown, BC, will throw it through. We'll put another blank on the board here in the second. BC holds the hammer. It is the women's final of the M&M Canadian Juniors. The Women's Championship Trophy, which will be presented. They've been playing for the Canadian Women's Junior Championship since 1971. But let's go back to 2001 and the championship that was played in St. Catharines, Ontario. Saskatchewan's Stephanie Miller against Suzanne Goody of PEI. Miller, the defending champion, undefeated heading into the final, but it didn't go her way. Suzanne Goody would win it 5-3, the final, the first of two Canadian junior women's titles for Suzanne Goody. And when you look at the lineup of teams this year at the Scotties that will be played starting next Saturday in Kingston, Ontario. Look at all the people, Russ, who have come through and won Canadian junior titles. Those are all the skips. Suzanne Goody, of course, now Suzanne Burt. Four! 2001, Suzanne Goody. So it is and has become a great road. Come down the Canadian Juniors road, and it will likely lead you to bigger and better things in Canadian curling.
It's incredible. We got 12 teams going to Kingston. Eight of them are right there, and it's what a field we got set up for that event. Who do you pick? You know, it's incredible. We don't even know which Jones is going to play better. You got Colleen back for the 253rd time, I think, out of Nova Scotia.
Yeah. Halfway tight. Not quite as many as you, though.
That's right.
Colleen
halfway tight.
Throwing the second stones for Marianne Arsenault, the Nova Scotia champion. It all begins next Saturday. In fact, Colleen was here most of the week because her son, Luke Saunders, was throwing the second stones for the Nova Scotia champions out of the Mayflower.
Boy, and they played well. They represented their province so well. They were fourth last year, third this year, same team. What a two great years.
Seven for sure. Oh, man. Eight on its own, 8-9. Great. Bring it down, girls. Okay, Shanna. Okay. We're out, yeah. Let's see. That's fine.
I talked to the Manitoba team before the game and congratulated them for winning the semi, and I asked them about the ice, and they said it was beautiful. Lots of curl, but a hair slower. All of a sudden, they're a little deep today, and the ice will change a little bit. It doesn't matter who the ice maker is, you can't keep it exactly the same, and it's an even better speed here, and I think they're getting caught a little bit, Victor. Maybe. Pretty deep on a few of those draws. There's another one.
Okay.
Well, yesterday, the arena that we're in, and there's a couple of them here at the Suncor Leisure Center. This is a cold little building, and it was a lot colder yesterday. I'm not quite as chilled today. It is much milder outside, and I'm just wondering if it's having that kind of effect.
Makes sense. It certainly does. A little warmer air temperature. The surface temperature itself, which is the key part, where the pebble is, where the rocks run, will be a little bit greasier. Yes, so that makes a big difference. Amazing what the ice makers have to do. In this case, Jamie Sage, you were trying to keep both surfaces similar because the curlers go back and forth. You love to play on the two spots that are pretty close to the same. The rocks will get straighter as the week goes along just through wear and tear. They polish themselves. So you have to start nipping the ice more, clipping more pebble off. It's a real balancing act just to get a surface close to being this good.
And what Russ is referring to, part of this huge complex, is the Oil Sands Curling Club. And so all you basically do is walk down a hall and turn left, and there are eight sheets. And that's where some of the championship was played this year.
Really hard! Really hard, girls, really hard! Nothing, there's nothing.
This really is some facility, isn't it? The rock climbing and squash, badminton, incredible gym that you've been in 3 or 4 hours a day, Vic?
Yes. Yeah. Just pumping.
Just
look at me. An Adonis. No, it is. It's
you got it.
One of Canada's fastest growing cities. Right now at about 100,000, and they are saying that they could be up to a couple of 100,000 within 10 years. And a great many people from Newfoundland. What did one gentleman say? That he thought there was upwards of 25,000 Newfoundlanders.
Somebody said the capital of Newfoundland is Fort Mac.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's unbelievable, isn't it?
Nice draw by Nicole Sigvaldason. It's now Manitoba sitting the two without Last Rock here in the third. Still looking for our first points on the board.
We're back to where we were last time, where you want to hang around here now. Yes, there's two in there. You'd love to throw extra weight and make a double, but try to hang around, maybe even roll behind this corner.
No.
Don't roll out.
Nice throw, Aaron.
And Will.
Really good throw.
That shot, with just about any other curling rocks I've ever played with, would have stayed in the rings. They're just that little bit livelier, and that's a big mistake.
So how do you deal with it? Do you have to pull back your weight? Do you try to hit it a little fuller? What do you do?
Yeah, bring the weight down a little bit, Vic. And when you're playing the rolls, when it's a high side roll, the rocks spin. When it's a low side roll, they don't spin as much and they don't roll as far. So you might want to play them the other way, but a little less weight's probably the easiest way to combat that.
7, 6,
mine's okay. Stay close.
Just stay
right here.
Go.
Make sure, guys.
6.
Right here. Yeah, finish it a bit.
Try it first.
Okay, whoa. Little. Good. Good. Nice shot.
Now, just watching Nicole here, little left, little right, that's unusual. Normally you keep the rock in a countered position so you, when you release it at 12 o'clock, the rock will spin the appropriate direction. A little backwards, a little forwards, it's kind of a unique thing. Sometimes you'll float the turn a little bit when you do that.
You're trying to roll it behind their corner. From this angle, it doesn't look like they've got anything tucked behind. But that's exactly what you were talking about here. Trying to maybe pull the white back on this. And
well, yeah, Vic, because it's a better way to, well, you can't even call that a miss. It's partly buried, but it's a better way to miss. You can't roll out.
It's too bad because it actually spun on itself and came back a bit.
That's those aggressive rocks again. The bottoms are very, very sharp. So when they do finish like that, they'll whip back the other direction. Too bad that would have been half buried. Again, hang around here. Look at nice, lots of ice. Under pressure, you want to put the broom on the edge of the rock so you know you're going to make contact. Good soft weight required here. Good chance to hang around.
10.
Close.
Here it comes with the lightweight.
Okay, I want to ask you something. Now, they're lined up here that you might try the double, and could you get the double and roll in behind your corner? Is that possible?
You might there. I think it is lined up pretty close to that, Vic. But the reason she rolled as far as she did, yes, it sets up a double, but if you don't roll at all, you leave it on the edge of the forefoot, it's this little flop of 3 or 4 inches, which is a much lower degree of difficulty for BC. Chance to roll behind the corner and score the 2 points. This way it rolls, she's going to have to roll, 5 feet to be buried. Even if you make it, you're going to be so far back in the rings, Manitoba will have a chance to get to it.
Yeah, you got it.
Again, a veteran move, really, to roll away from that corner.
Normal.
Yeah. Oh.
Really close.
Corryn Brown.
Yeah.
From the Kamloops. Curling club.
Yeah, hard. Oh, yeah, roll, Sid. Go, Sid. Yeah, roll. Yes. Go.
There's that roll. There's that roll. Oh, it looks like it'll pop out the other side, but it hangs on at the back edge of the 12.
Talk about the lively rocks again. Soft weight, hits it right where she wants. She makes a great double. Watch what happens here, though. The vice doesn't come in. The opposition vice could run in there and sweep that. And I think, Vic, I think if she'd got on that soon enough, you might have been able to sweep that out of the rings. Just hanging on. What a great shot.
Line, caught, line.
Final stone, Manitoba. Shannon Birchard from the St. Vital in Winnipeg.
All right, Shannon.
Okay,
let it go.
Okay, now that stone out in front. It's on the M&M. Too far to split.
It's close, Vic, and the reason I'm questioning it, it, usually you wouldn't, but with this type of action on these rocks, I think it would be possible, but you look at it and you go, what are my odds? You know, it's probably 40%, 30% you're going to make that.
Okay.
That means you're going to probably be forced to a single, and at this point in time, BC's quite happy to do what they're doing. Interesting, another blank.
Mm-hmm.
Small thing, but another good move to play a spot in the ice you haven't played and try to learn it.
Eight, nine. Nine? Eight, nine.
So for a third time, we'll put a blank on the board. BC, Manitoba, it's the women's final. M&M Meat Chops, Canadian Junior. The NHL on TSN continues Tuesday, and it's a doubleheader. First up, the Montreal Canadiens are in Tampa Bay, and then immediately following that, the Wild in Vancouver. Live coverage gets underway 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific on TSN and TSN Mobile TV. Lots of support for BC and Manitoba. This women's final, the M&M Meat Chops Canadian Juniors. We go to the fourth, and it's still three blanks on the board. Both teams have had their chances, Russ, but to manage to get out of them with some nice shot making. And once again here in this fourth, it will be BC. It does have the last rock. They have the hammer playing the red stone.
And Manitoba just sliding that inch too far and a chance to hit a rock that's no longer in the free guard zone. They'd love to stick it and stay outside the ring so it cannot be removed.
Yep, right over. That's fine. Okay. Maybe something here now, huh? She wants to sit right there.
Yeah, that's smart. I like that. At some point in time, the team without hammer has to force here. That's the goal.
Yeah.
Try to force a single. Obviously, a steal would be even better, but forcing a single would be job number one.
Whoa. No, never.
Okay. Won't be able to hold the shooter. There we go. First time that we've seen BC make the move, and Corryn Brown goes out and taps for the guard.
You see BC later in the end here throw a takeout. Just watch how hard it comes down. It comes down a little bit softer weight than the Manitoba team. And been a few more rollouts by Manitoba, and they're all on the high side. And that's just a little extra adrenaline, a little extra speed. And again, with these lively rocks, you have to keep that control of that takeout weight.
Yesterday, it was the men's final here at the M&M Meat Chops Canadian Juniors. Manitoba and Matt Dunstone from the West Kildonan Curling Club against Thomas Scoffin and Alberta out of the Saville Sports Center. 3-3 as they play in 10, and watch this. Bang, that up weight. So much a factor in the game of Dunstone and Colton Lott, Dan Grant, and Brendan McCouche. And it's nice to have you join us. I can tell what province you're from. That's a nice hat.
Hey, guys. Thanks for having me. The girls supported us great yesterday, so we thought we'd return the favor to them today.
Hey, congratulations. You have a little while to think about it. I don't know if somewhere in your mind, you're 17, that you thought you'd ever be in this position, have you?
It's been my dream ever since I was a kid, and to know that it's finally come true, it's the greatest feeling in the world.
Is that, Matt, is that a Mike McEwen delivery or a Jeff Stoughton?
I'm not totally sure. It's kind of unique.
You got the same brushes though.
I know that. I know my pre-game or my pre-shot warm-up is kind of the same as Jeff's, and that's just because he was my idol ever since I was a kid. So I kind of followed in his footsteps there.
Not a bad idol to have. Jeff just won the province again for the 10th time.
No, I know that's unbelievable. Good for them. They lost their tough 1-1 game, but I was glad to see them pull through.
Have you you thought now about you're going to represent? Canada, you're going to wear the maple leaf at the World Juniors, and they're going to be played in Sochi, Russia. So you'll be on the ice. That all starts February 28th, so you'll be on the Olympic ice.
Yeah, it's we're really looking forward to that. We're almost like guinea pigs for the 2014 Olympics for when the big curlers get there. So we're really looking forward to that, and it's going to be a pretty neat experience.
Talk to me a little bit about the fact that I'd heard, Matt, that you're very cool on the ice, yet you do explode. You have this emotion, but it's controlled emotion. Am I right?
Occasionally I can get a little wild. Obviously, when the shot was made last night, my outer personality came out.
Well, that's the perfect thing. So listen, you're good for TV because you lead us right into it.
Yeah.
There are NBA teams now calling about this hang time that you got on this and the jump. I mean, that's Listen, but that's what it's all about, right? You win it, you better show some emotion. Look at you. That's great stuff.
Yeah, well, I'll have to let them know I'm only 5'7", so.
Hey, another Spud Webb. You never know.
Oh, yeah, right.
And listen, you wear the skater shoes. I love that, too.
Yeah, I've worn running shoes ever since I was a little boy, so it's just been normal for me. And I don't plan on changing it anytime soon.
Now, listen, before you go, and we'll let you go so you can watch and support the team, you have some very, very loyal Twitter followers.
Yeah.
Now, they have gotten to me, and I guess I was saying Dunstan, and I may have even said Dunstein at some time, at a point in time. So they said, look, Vic, it's Dunstone. So, listen, what I can say, and I know I can say properly, is champion. So congratulations.
Thanks a lot, Vic.
All right, and I apologize.
No problem. I
appreciate
it.
Great, and good luck in Sochi.
Yeah, thank you very
Thanks,
much.
Thanks, Matt. All the best to you.
Thanks.
It's curling, Vic. Stone.
Stone, yes, yeah.
What a great young man. Eh?
He is. Look at this, the flip in behind.
It's so hot.
Here in the fourth.
Yeah.
And you know, Nicole Sigvaldason maybe a little bit nervous to start. We saw her miss a couple of shots, but there gets one and to roll right
That's
in behind
like
her guard closest to the center.
I was talking earlier about a little bit too much weight out of Manitoba. That was perfect. Well swept.
If you end up back there, it's not terrible. Okay.
Two choices here. You could play the run back and try to open it up. You could cross it and definitely open it up. There'd still be a red guard also. Be a little more aggressive here and try to come around it. Pretty straight spot, though. They're only taking about 2.5 feet of ice here.
Mine's good.
Mine only.
Top eight.
Go around.
Yep.
You'd have to think they've got to brush this to get it by.
Well, then. No balance, guys.
Sit.
Okay, we should have just gone around. Okay.
I think that was the original call to freeze, and then they tried to get it by. Little opportunity here. The yellow's poked right in behind the corner.
Mm-hmm. You got it.
You really want to roll away here because if you hit it dead on, there'll be a double and the red might be buried. So in this case, a rollout is better than dead on.
Nine.
Whoa.
Nine. Beast?
Oh, boy.
Ooh, he's got to finish hard.
Eight.
And nothing.
Are they shot? That?
Yeah. Not.
Yeah. Sure. Like, if you get straight draw, we'll kind of try that.
Okay.
Do you like
touch
it?
More. Yeah. Same weight or a little more?
That should be, touch more, maybe.
Touch more.
Not a lot.
I got 3.9. So 3.8.
You got it?
Let's go.
So are they trying to little split, hit and roll here?
Yeah, it's either a split or an outside tap. You want to get one of them in behind cover would be the main thing. And then you have to worry about where the shooter goes. You don't want to set up a double. So crossing it like they're doing is a smart play. Let's hit about half of it to a third.
Boy, they don't want to go through this hole here.
Really hard to get anything.
They need a piece here. Don't want to go through this hole. Oh, they did. Right through the middle. And out the back. That's the story of the game so far, to my mind. Both teams have had their chances to set themselves up for something and haven't been able to take advantage.
Yeah, in fairness, that was great weight. It just had to make contact, and it over-curled for whatever reason. Pretty straight spot, and it curled nicely. And
you got it.
She'd love that one back.
Interestingly enough, she was looking for a little more weight.
Yeah, which would have made it run that much straighter. It would have then made contact, and good point. You have to be so precise with these rocks that curl.
Nine.
Yep.
Four. Shannon will have this spot figured out now.
Four.
A little roll would be nice.
Whoa.
Skip stones and rolls it away.
Great stone. It can't really be used by BC to roll. BC has to come around a rock that's in the top of the 12 foot. It's tough to hide more than half of it here.
Yeah.
What kind of weight?
3.94.
3.94.
think. Just throw it down.
We can sweep it.
Okay.
We'll find out now. In fact, the ice is straightened up a little bit.
I saw Alberta in the men's game yesterday have a little trouble burying in this area.
Tommy.
It will go. There's definitely finish at the end. It's just when it crosses that center line.
All there. Can't go. We're all there. Back.
Well, the line's going to be good, but I don't like where the weight is.
Line's pretty
back
good.
Eight.
How?
It's through.
Whoa.
Okay, that's fine.
And
sorry, you're a good line.
And out the back.
It's way keener than 3-9, then.
Skips it.
You said throw 3-9. I threw it, so it was just getting keener.
Yeah.
Way keener than 3-9. Assuming she means 3-9 from back line to the hog, which is the majority of the teams will time from. That's not even close to the right time, Becky. They need more like a 3-8, 3-80, something like that.
Okay.
Let's do this. 90? 95? Four. Four. Okay. I got 3-9 on that one, which should be really close speed-wise.
Gotta go four.
A lot lighter than the last rocket was thrown.
Five, six.
Four.
Can't go.
Five.
Five, six. Can't go.
We're fine. We're fine.
Good.
I'm not sure if they can just hit this right on the nose and be shot because that other stone in the 12 just looks like it is nibbling the top edge.
You'd probably come this way, Vic, if you get close enough to this guard. That's the key thing. If you're comfortable enough to take on this guard, you could definitely hit it, roll this way. You've got the saber.
Yeah,
absolutely. And you definitely you slide into this area here. A little dangerous here because you're going a little wider. It might be a little slower here, and we know what happened with our last one. So chances are you're going to, if you're human at all, you're going to protect light.
Timeout has been called by BC, and so that'll
bring probably
snow
the top.
Ken Brown, the BC coach,
down to the
ice.
Like if you can get inside,
to the inside.
Or you can roll that way. It's easy to roll this way, though.
So you don't have to get to the inside. You can get to the outside and roll a little bit, too. And if you hit it dead on with enough weight, it'll slide forward a little bit.
Really and truly, you know, if you're going out wider, you just missed the draw. I would get the draw weight first, I think, and you just got to get to the inside of that. You can't hurt yourself getting to the inside because it goes into the other one and you're shot, okay? So no matter what, you can hit any weight, okay? Just to the inside.
Ken is a former BC champ. He played with Barry McPhee, who was a golf pro in Kamloops and represented the province.
Anywhere in the inside is... Bruce was just saying we'll get them shot rock, but I truly believe you can actually hit it dead on and still be shot because it'll actually slide forward a little wee bit.
Did you like what Ken said also? Look, you just threw one through. You don't have your draw weight. Get that first before you attempt that draw.
That's an honest thing to say, isn't it? Because it's true. It doesn't mean she was going to miss the draw.
No.
So she's got to get across the face of this.
We've got the other double here if they have to.
Oh, and she rolled it the in and will grab enough of the 8 foot the other way. So we have our first point on the board. BC has the lead. Manitoba will have their first hammer when we come back. British Columbian Corryn Brown are finally on the board, scoring one in the fourth. And she had just thrown a stone through, facing three. This is a big shot.
Yeah, great timeout by Ken. I think Ken Brown, lots of experience there. She just missed the draw. She had to go into a new path with the draw. It would have been a bit of a guess. You can hit this on the left side or the right side, as long as you don't roll too far. Well thrown. Good timeout.
The key shot is brought to you by sponge towels, paper towels. Nothing absorbs like it. Here at the Suncor Community Leisure Center in Fort McMurray. On the oil patch for this year's M&M Meat Chops Canadian Juniors. And for the first time in the game, Manitoba. And the team from the St. Vital, skipped by 18-year-old Shannon Birchard, will have the last rock. They have the hammer playing the yellow stone.
I just don't think you'll bury.
Great lesson there in that timeout, Vic. It was a simple draw. It was a simple hit. But you're in the Canadian Championship. You hit and roll out, they steal two. You hit the wreck and the guard, they steal three. You miss the draw, they steal three. There was risk either way. Why not play the shot you're comfortable with? And you just missed the draw as heavy as she did. I thought that was a wonderful move. You see that in the golf business all the time. If somebody's struggling with their driver, they start hitting the three wood. You have to go with what's working that day. And it was a well-timed timeout.
Let it curl up to spin.
Top four.
Let it curl up.
Top four.
Key, actually, roll yours, Aaron. Yeah, roll yours. No, don't actually. Yeah, maybe just roll it. Just touch, Aaron. Just touch. Just a touch. Okay, set it up, bud.
And then a five wood or a hybrid. And
yeah.
And then you pull out the five iron. Yeah. And then just hit it a seven around.
And keep the ball retriever in the bag.
That's it.
You got it.
It used to be a wonderful show that I was on PBS about, it was a husband, a father and daughter, rather.
9-5-10.
I think it was how to break 90, and all he carried was a seven iron, a wedge, and a putter.
Yes.
And the whole thing was to hit the wedge, hit the seven, 150.
Get it in play.
Keep it in play. Rolling it away from the center guard.
Control or normal? Which one?
Normal? Got it. Control!
Control weight.
Right off, never. No. Right
these rocks will really spin just if you hit them on the high side. Down. See how far this rolls.
Okay.
Yes.
Right.
Touch up.
Yeah. No, she barely touched it as well.
And not overthrown either. Maybe a hair outside of the broom.
Four?
Yeah. 95-4.
Okay.
Let's make it.
Yeah.
First real good aggressive opportunity for Manitoba.
9-10.
Really can't go.
We know this spot's quick.
Coming down. 9. Oh. 8.
Nine. They want to hear 6 and 5, not 9 and 8.
Still on here?
Starting to slow down.
Too late. We're fine. Go. Right.
Realize we were still on that.
Get a couple licks to the broom, could hit a little more of that red one, redirect it right in behind the yellow.
Quick release. Go. Board.
Little up. Little up.
Fine only. Close. Clean.
Roll. Yeah, roll it. Yeah.
Look at that beautiful soft weight.
Right over. Yes, go.
There's that roll, and now getting a piece tucked down, maybe a little corner. As mentioned, 14 men's, 14 women's teams began play last weekend, and those not involved in the championship round or the playoffs then got a chance to play some mixed doubles. They mixed up the teams, and of course, mixed doubles curling is growing in popularity. And all the teams got a chance to play either here in the arena or on the curling club, the Oil Sands Curling Club. And, of course, this year, the World Mixed Doubles Championship will be played in Fredericton, April the 13th through the 20th. World Mixed Doubles is coming to Canada.
Scrubbing there at the end, that one virtually all the way down. Really, this has not got a little much extra room here to get by.
These mics keep going down.
That's good.
Hack weight, great choice of speed here.
Hack.
Yep.
Oh, and only.
Yep. Oh.
Yes.
Whoa.
Yep.
Yes.
Boy, if they can ever get a little flipped in behind their own guard.
No. It's close.
They'll roll it away.
Two choices for Manitoba here. You want to hide it undercover. You want to create some more difficulty for your opponent. You can roll right behind the red one or behind your own yellow, and it makes way more sense to roll behind the yellow. A, it's yours, and B, it's a longer raise.
It turns out to be plan A as he gets it half, three quarters tucked.
Kudos to Shannon Birchard for making that audible halfway down. And a lot of teams are hoping it's going to curl.
More than that, it's totally covered.
Is it ever?
Roll it.
Aaron Pincott throwing the third stones.
Sit.
And will it sit? No, it'll spin out.
Really good opportunity. First good one for Manitoba so far.
How am I coming right here? Like a six?
No, dear. Everybody's been deep in this spot. Like can they throw it to the brushers? Throw it three. Throw it two and a half. Give it to your brushers. Half buried would be real good.
Well, the other thing, too, isn't a placement to avoid setting up a double.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. In behind the T line, there'll be a double off that center rock.
Mine's good. Yeah,
six,
move it
seven.
Up. Okay, wall room.
Seven.
Wall.
Six.
Mine's nice. Wall room.
All you.
Room.
Five.
Room.
Just
room.
Five.
Yelling six. Six is perfect.
Six, seven. We're seven.
Just even then.
Even?
Even.
Six. Well, we're a little back.
Eight.
Whoa. Okay, just too deep again. Both teams are being fooled, Becky. You can tell by the sweeping calls. They were yelling six, five. I heard a number as low as five, which means it would have stopped about 4 or 5 feet short of that rock. And it ended up past a seven, a deep seven. So they're getting a little bit fooled with this great speed. Doubles there.
Where should you as a front end, particularly a front end, where should you know, if you've seen enough stones, where should you have confidence in saying where that rock is going to be? Should it be by the hog line? Should it be by the top of the house? Where should you know?
Sooner the better, Vic. And, you know, years ago, people didn't really know De La Farr hog line, and you watch the top front ends now, the Stoughton's front end, Martin's front end, Glenn's front end, they know instantaneously. They probably know by the first hog line, and that makes it so much more effective with their brushing. There it is.
One and out the side. Look at that. Very nice. Corryn Brown. You don't put the stone in the right spot, then you'll get punished.
You look at Corryn all week, Vic. She was tied for first at skip, so that's impressive enough. But the rest of the team was T9, T4, T5. So that means her shots, her degree of difficulty was a little tougher than some of the other teams. And she ended up tied for first, so she made a lot of big shots. No bigger than that one. The offense now.
Mine's good, guys. Yes.
Could have hit the back one and blanked the end. They're going to go for the two here.
Whoa. Seven.
Where?
Seven, eight.
Whoa. Not too deep.
Eight, eight, nine.
Six.
You know what?
Go.
And it'll stop at the back edge. I'm not sure. They really didn't come very close to that guard at all.
No. But you heard seven again, Vic. And seven's T-line. They were wrong by 3 feet. And then it's blistering fast. The other thing that happens with arena is A, that you've got fast speed underfoot. B, it's quick to begin with. That inside out shot's always fast historically. But the other thing that's happening is a lot of rocks have been down the same spot, and the actual surface temperature has been proven by the top ice makers. Kind it actually Christmas warms up bit. That little bit extra, and you get that little greasiness. You get a little more speed again, and both teams have been fooled here.
So final stone here for BC. She wants to go where?
Probably around it high or right to the back one if she has
where?
To. She has to be careful going deep. She might set up a double. So just T-line would be nice, partially buried, and that will force Manitoba to a single.
Hey, make it second.
It's not light either.
Whoa, you guys.
Okay, back here then. No for line.
Make it freeze it, Erin.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
And it will stay there for a second. And now the double for two, possibly.
Oh, I think it might be Vic. The key thing, the double's there, yes. You can hit it here. This is gone for sure.
But you touch it?
You might, Vic. Yeah. You just might get a piece of this yellow one here.
Because then if we just touch it, it might not move it all the way out, you know?
I think it's there.
If we just nose, that's okay, right?
The next problem is the angle you have to hit that up, Vic. There's a good chance with these lively rocks you'll roll too far. It has to be made with like a hack weight at most. Be the Ed Wernick double here, Vic. Just a little soft. Throw it to the brusher, hack waiter.
Mm-hmm. It's all right.
And the way the stones behave, the way the ice is, you almost want to underthrow it.
Exactly. Yeah, you're absolutely correct.
Okay,
you got it.
Main thing here is hang around. You can't be too aggressive. If you hit it high side, jam it. It's a steal of one. So make sure you get a good chunk of that one. A lot of speed here.
Well, both teams have had their chances for twos.
Whoa,
here's an opportunity, as tough as it may be, for Manitoba to maybe get the first deuce of the game. Final stone. Touch it on the way back. Oh, she did as you thought, and there will go the shooter two. So a break on one side. You know, you didn't get it, disappointment, but then you get the break to roll out. You still hold the hammer. We're halfway through. Well, as mentioned, for the first time, team from Nunavut represented at this year's M&M Canadian Meat Shop Juniors, the women's champions from Iqaluit, the men's champions from Rankin Inlet. Congratulations on a wonderful week here in Fort McMurray. 14 men's teams, 14 women's, and we're down now to the final two here in women's play. BC and Manitoba, as we go to six, BC leads 1-0, and once again, Manitoba will have the last rock. They have the hammer playing the yellow stones. I was saying to Russ during the fifth end break, you almost want to underthrow. You purposely want to underthrow things. You look at a double and you think automatically, well, I have to throw double weight. With this ice, these stones, it may be difficult to realize it, but you have to take something off.
Yeah, you do. You had the adrenaline, Canadian final. Good surface to slide on. It's so hard. And here's another example. There's a good chance this corner guard will go in the rings. Don't forget, this is the fifth end break. They shammy the ice for quite a while. That warms this rock speed up also. They got to get this to slow down. There they go. First red one by BC, deep also. It's hard to explain on television, but the ice changes all the time. It's very subtle, but this level, the slightest little miscalculation, the misguess in a certain lane, in a certain spot in the ice, can cost you a championship.
Top four,
top eight.
Top four. Make sure the line. Sure. A little slippery there, Sam.
Just a bit.
Oh, there you go. It's a little slippery. Maybe that's that greasiness you were talking about. Let's take a look at the numbers after five in a game where both teams have had their chances but made critical mistakes.
It is that greasiness that's causing the difference here. It's a little bit warmer in here. We can feel it up in the booth even. A little bit faster because of that. 62% for draw for BC, 67% for Manitoba. That's awfully low. The team that wins this is going to make that adjustment in the last half.
The numbers after five are brought to you by Tim Hortons Premium Brand Coffee. Always 20 minutes fresh.
Yeah, whoa.
Yeah,
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 whoa.
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 No,
runs it by and rolls it over. What a lovely shot. Mariah Mundor throwing the lead stones.
They were trying harder for the hit and roll, which I really give them credit for, than the double. Most teams would want to get the enemy stones out of there, but rolling buried was the key. But it just, again, because of the surface, the fast rocks, it just slid a half a rock too far. This is accessible on the outturn side, but we haven't played out this wide. Could curl.
Sam Fisher, big stroke. Now got it by that guard. Yeah, he did. Oh, and they'll hang it there.
That's a well-thrown stone, not overthrown again. That's BC's mantra. Not only hit that half-buried rock, but stayed. Roughly 4 feet of ice taken here. Has to get off the line to get the maximum curl.
6-7.
Got to move right.
6-7.
Yep.
Close. Yeah.
Starting to curl.
Whoa.
7.
Whoa.
7-8.
Right first. Boom. Right first.
8-8.
8-9. Yeah. Take it back. Yep. Straight back. Hard. Oh, wait.
Pretty good shot. It's almost the exact right weight, but wouldn't you love to have it that little bit lighter? Then when the opponent comes down, they can only see a piece of it, and this rock comes into play, a possible jam. Just still, not quite throwing them light enough. Close.
Yeah, got it. Same weight.
Control. Let's go.
Same weight.
Right off.
A little more.
Yep.
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 Roll it in.
Yep.
No forward.
Roll.
Yep. Yep.
No
roll.
And rolls it over to sit back button to cover their own, but sitting three, British Columbia without last rock here in the sixth.
Try to roll it back. The double's obviously there, but that roll would be really nice into the 8 foot area.
The bolt and the roll, and it'll spin to a stop behind cover, back tee line, edge of the eight.
Couldn't draw it any better than that. That's fully under cover.
Shane Andries, who throws the second stones.
The hit's not available, so it forces BC to play a finesse shot.
I think it's all there, guys.
T, line only. Yep, really close, yep.
Yep.
It's a tighter line than the last come around. They have to make sure this gets by.
Right down on the corner, and you said whoever would figure out the ice first and the weight in particular will have the advantage.
That's the best draw we've seen. That's just perfect speed. Six is the number you want to hear because they can brush it a bit if they have to.
Seven.
Nicole Sigvaldgudson.
Hard.
I'm trying to hold it on that side if they can. Nicely done. And for the first time in the game, we're seeing the brushers actually come into play.
Exactly. And the best players in the world throw it to the brushers, and they finally cut the leg drive a little bit. I think the coaches We're probably preaching that in the fifth end break, handing out some parachutes and slowing them down a little bit. And it's hard. It really is. The surface is so beautiful to slide on. That hog line shows up in a hurry. That it bumped it a hair farther. The red would be removable.
No, never.
Have to be careful here. Anything deep, this looks hot.
All there.
No.
How up?
No.
Back.
No.
Might set up a red double here.
Okay.
Nope.
Pushes that red right back onto the corner.
I get more.
Spins in to sit the shot stone.
Take the intern. If you do this, that's okay.
Okay.
Okay, let's do that. Do you want to just play 10?
Sure.
Okay.
All right, Nick.
Let's go. You got it.
I really feel it's hard to tell from up here. I really feel Manitoba's starting to get that confidence.
Mm-hmm.
You got a chance here. They can roll buried. Dangerous if you don't roll far enough, or you can roll to the wide side. And I think they've elected to go wide side.
Whoa.
9-5.
Separate the two.
Mondor, Andries. And that stone will spill out the back. But now, is there a yellow double?
Yeah, they were hoping to roll this way. Once they didn't have that, they called it over this way and didn't quite. They would have loved to have swept it a little sooner and get a little more angle. Now that double is definitely there. Straight down, half a rock, hits it perfectly. Not only that, they might be able to sit underneath cover here.
Do you like it?
Yeah. You know, less than half for the double. Are you throwing 9?
9.
Okay.
I think this is thick enough. You can hit the second yellow
on
the top half and roll up a little bit, Vic, which will put it underneath the cover.
Are we caught in the, like, on the side? Or no?
There you
go. Okay.
Interesting choice of turns here. Just a lot of times you play it the other way, but you want to play the one you're happy with. Just a curl 3 inches.
No.
This is outside the line, Vic.
Skip stones. Here in 6.
Okay.
Bangs it right on the beak. It's a curious thing, isn't it?
Like that.
And it's not to be even think of picking on them for this reason. But you've just seen what your teammates have done. Pull it back, give it to the brushers, and now she's trying or seemed to want to do it all by herself.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's just the way it is. Hitting it dead on is a pretty good option here because that's a very steep angle. You have to hit it so thin you could completely miss it. I think they're going to try to hit it dead on. You could roll over to the other option that I illustrated, but if you don't roll perfectly, there will be a yellow double.
But if she does hit it and roll away, is there a red double too? An angle double?
Yeah, possibly. Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Possibly, Vic. I think they're calling dead on here with just a control weight. 9's a lot of weight.
Just that much too far. Manitoba sits still 1. Wow. I mean, this, say what you will, yes, the rocks are lively, and that's part of the game, but that's just frustrating when you do that.
Oh, yeah. No kidding. That was just so close to perfect, but this is a dangerous situation. How do you get those out, Vic? You're going to tap them onto your own. If you ever come down and try to freeze and you're light, there might be an opportunity to tap this rock out later.
Yeah, I think so. And if you are a guard, that's fine.
You come down here and you're a little deep, there will be a double for 3, Vic.
Okay, try.
Just throw sweepers.
So we talked about we're back to perfect draw weight. This has no leeway one way or the other. Big shot.
It's like freeze it, guys.
Freeze it. 4-1, friend.
Yeah.
It's really fast. Throw it to us.
Yeah.
four, oh, there you go.
One.
Well, we said yesterday, we heard it in the men's game too, that you want a front end that says, give us the stone. We'll get you there. That's, you just heard that. Give it to us.
Where?
Four.
To it.
Oh.
To it.
Line only. It's good.
To it.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Well, here it is now. It's up to them. Sam Fisher, Sydney Fraser. Got to get it by that corner guard first, though. Now Aaron Pincott, two. Right down on the corner. Oh, what a shot. Had a big time, an important time for BC.
Really bad break that Corryn's shot didn't hang a little more and become shot rockers. That was glued on there from the get-go. What perfect speed. You heard them say 4.0. That's more like the speed you need. Really unfortunate overcrow by Hare, but still forces down to a deuce here for Manitoba if it's made.
So the shot stone is the stone just on the tee line. In the 8 foot, Manitoba sitting one, final stone on the way here in six.
Six!
Make it good, guys. Make it nice. Make it nice. Line's good.
Good 4 foot.
Oh, gotta go. You got it.
Gotta go. Five!
You got it hard!
Hard, you got it. Right here.
Andries, Mondor.
Go, go, go. Go, go, go.
Go, girls. Hard, hard, hard.
Little more. Take it down. Put it in the eight. And it'll slide to the form. We have our first deuce. And Manitoba with their first lead, 2-1 through six. Well, there's a moment when it all changes. Right, Russ? When nothing makes sense. Right, Russ? And everything around you turns to chaos. Yes, Vic, that's true.
Right, Vic?
Yeah, this is that moment. Starting Friday, school will never be the same. All new episodes of Degrassi return Friday, 9 Eastern only on Much. Manitoba with a 2-1 lead over BC as we welcome you back to the Suncor Community Leisure Center here in Fort McMurray. Boy, we saw some terrific shots. Wonderful shots. That last one made by Corryn Brown to glue it on the corner. And as you pointed out, she doesn't make that shot, rolls to another spot. There may have been a double for a three.
Oh, no question about it. And a great roll by Shannon to set it up, too. And a nice draw for two. And both teams virtually at the same time have really got the handle on this quick ice. And we're going to have a real finish here.
So here in the seventh, it will be British Columbia that once again has the last rock. They have the hammer. Playing the red stones.
It's like top 8 for this one.
Okay,
tuck a little piece behind my guard.
Just a fraction deep on the first one. I'd love to have it in front of the tee line, obviously.
Line's good. Reed's good. Five. Five, just five.
Five's good.
Just five.
Gotta move.
Gotta move.
Six. Where?
Six, six, seven.
Whoa.
Six. Right to it.
Okay, gotta move.
Little bounce.
Hard bounce
at
heart.
Okay,
sorry. Okay.
Well, let's take a moment to go back to 1995 in the Canadian Junior Curling Championship in Regina. The final, Kelly McKenzie, Manitoba, Ontario's Kirsten Harmark, and Ontario would have their problems as McKenzie would steal singles in four straight ends. And then they shook after nine as Manitoba wins it. 5-2 the final, and McKenzie, who is now, of course, Kelly Scott, wins the 1995 Canadian Juniors. And we say hello to Miss Scott, who joins us now from Kelowna. How are you?
Hello, everybody. I'm great, thank you.
Yeah,
just
we have
getting over a cold, so I'm feeling better.
Okay, well, we're glad about that. It's been a while since we've talked with you. And now, of course, you're going to be at the Scotties, which starts next weekend, next Saturday in Kingston. Won another BC championship. Tell us about it, please.
Yeah, no, it was a battle. We had a few losses midweek, and really kind of turned things on come playoff time at the end of the week. So We started playing better when we really had to, and felt really good going into the Page playoff game.
Hi, Kelly. Russ here. Congratulations.
You
turned it around in the provincials like you did last year in the Scots. You had a great comeback last year. Why is it that you have all these returnees year after year after year?
I don't know. It's interesting. I think the teams that do travel and play on the tour are often the teams that emerge from their provincials in both men's and women's. So I guess when you put in the time, I guess you do get benefits down the road.
Well, when you talk about returning teams, familiar faces such as yourself and Jennifer and Holman now, of course, I think one of the more interesting stories will be Nova Scotia. Marianne Arsenault is skipping the team, but there is Colleen Jones back and throwing the second stones. Kim Kelly is with her. Nancy Delahunt, part of that team, just the fifth player. So we have some wonderful returning faces.
Yeah, that was the team that we always looked up to, and I think if you asked anyone on our team on, you know, what was one of our highlight games in our career, it was probably a 1-2 Page playoff game that we had against those ladies, and it was just a great, well-played game and really fun, so we're looking forward to playing against them again.
Now, yesterday in the men's final, we had Alberta and Thomas Scoffin, who made his first appearance at the Canadian Juniors as a 12-year-old. That's the youngest. But you made your first appearance as at how what age, please?
I was 11. Or no, I'm sorry. I think I was 13. That year that we lost the Canadian final, yeah.
Well, here it is. We have some pictures of that. And there you are, 1991 to be exact. And you were playing with Jennifer Jones, of course.
You betcha. That's where it all began.
That was you in the middle of that huddle, did you see? And so here you are all these years later, and my, how you've grown.
Oh, yes. Drastically. That's right.
You know what's interesting to my mind is when you look at some of the pairings, I'm thinking of yourself and Gina have been playing a long time together. As we watch BC and Fraser wrap one around, they do have the last rock, but it is Manitoba sitting one back edge of the button. Jill Officer, Jen Jones have been together since their junior days. What is it about certain pairings? What is it about Gina, for example, and you and how you've clicked for so many years?
Yeah, once you find a combination that clicks, it's something you want to hang on to. And certainly, it's a hard thing to find, but when it does click, you know that it's something very special. And certainly, Sasha, Gina, and myself have a lot of games under our belts together, and we're super excited to have, you know, with Scotty's experience now with Sarah as our lead. And we've been battling against, I guess, Jill Officer and Jennifer Jones ever since their junior careers, so now we get to do it in women's.
Now, this... just want to ask you about this game in particular. When you think back, BC hasn't won a women's title in junior play since Julie Sutton in 1987. Every other province has won it since then. A reason for it, you think?
I'm not exactly sure. To tell you the truth, that does surprise me because I know that our BC junior girls have been in the running quite a few times in the semifinal or final. So maybe this year is our year to break through.
Kelly, we thank you very much. We do hope you're feeling better by the time next weekend rolls around, and we'll look forward to seeing you in Kingston.
Thank you. We can't wait.
Okay, Kelly, thanks very much. Kelly Scott joining us from Kelowna. She will represent BC, the two-time Canadian champion.
Boy, this has to curl in a hurry, Vic. This could be disaster.
It's not terrible.
And everything settles. Everything is back of the tee line. BC with last rock here.
It's sliding and sliding.
Luckily for BC, the rocks ended up behind the tee line, but a well-placed rock here is going to create a lot of chaos here for British Columbia later in the end. Just rolled them deep enough there. A little lucky that didn't jam.
Okay. Six. Whoa. Whoa, then just five.
Six.
Whoa. Half have to be short here.
Six, seven.
No.
Six.
Six.
Line's six.
Close.
We gotta wait. Six, seven. Seven.
Line's really good.
Six.
Sit down.
Yep.
Whoa. Whoa. Whoa.
Yeah. Hard.
That's nice stuff there to get it to the top four and behind those long guards.
Gotta go, Nick.
Well thrown rock, just barely light enough to catch that curl and almost fully hidden. Run this back and get the one that was just thrown, but there's two in the side, yellow ones on the side. If you could hit and stay with this red raise, that would really change
hard.
Things.
Hard. Yep, hard! Real hard! Yep! Yes, girls!
What's that?
That works.
She'll catch her own, but leave that shooter okay. Still out in front, just off center line.
Touch tight, if anything. I should give you more ice there.
Okay. Felt all right, there. But.
Let me see, but is there a fifth one in there? Yeah. I can't. So just. Yeah, we could be right on center, and that's
yeah,
okay.
Half over
a
this
tough
one.
Shot. It does go a little more here. Nice. Give me a little more.
Nice comment from Corryn when Aaron slid down. She was a little bit narrow, and Corryn said, look, I don't think I give you enough ice. And that's what makes the great teams even better is that awareness. And instead of saying, oh, you must have missed the broom, and blaming it somebody else, it's just keep communicating. These big games talk
yeah,
all the time.
Bite the 12. Okay, you can be a three, that's okay.
Okay. 4:05, 4:10.
Come on, another weight. You got it.
Yeah.
You know what to throw.
Haven't been too many rocks on the intern side here, out to past middle 12 foot. Did like about 4.5 feet of curl here.
Three, four.
Four, five.
Good, guys. Four is good.
Four.
It. Three.
Right here.
Clean.
Whoa, if you can. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Clean it.
Three, four.
Four.
Just wait. Just
four.
Touch. We just have to touch that on.
Whoa, let it stop on its own.
Okay. Okay, that's okay. Great weight.
Her eyes are always on the target.
Oh, that's fantastic. Just you know where the rock is. You're balanced. The shoulders are square. The rock's going to come out right where you want it. Keep your eye on the broom. That's a wonderful habit to get into.
You try it. At least be second shot, right? Control?
I think so.
Easy to take.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nose isn't bad. Nose is fine.
Yeah.
Try to get a touch to the inside.
Okay.
Control?
Control or what?
Yep.
Nose isn't
two
terrible.
Ways you could tap back all the yellows and create a bit of a wall, but I think what they're going to try to do is come down here with soft weight and just get that inside flop, and that'll eliminate a lot of red yellows.
Control. Yep. Whoa. Yep. Whoa. Close.
Anything.
Shot stone still back four. That belongs to Manitoba.
Impressive throw by Corryn Noel because it just rolled enough, I think.
How much can you see this one? I just want to.
I'll let you know.
I don't think you can see much.
I don't think you can see any. I think you can see a piece. I think you can see enough.
That one? Like,
yeah, the top one.
A little bit.
Not
quite
so high.
A quarter.
She doesn't have
you
to
come
hit
around
much of it to get
like
all three.
What if you come around on
do
that
you like coming
way,
this
top
way?
Four?
Yeah, not bad.
I mean,
what, you leave her
don't mind it. That's not hard though.
Yeah, but it's for one.
If you come like here,
if
you
mine should
here,
take it right to there,
then that tap rolls off.
Yeah, to take it right there. If we're here, that's okay. I'm just worried about this double for three.
Yeah.
Like, she's only got a shot for one at this point, right?
Okay, let's go here.
Go right there.
Trying to go, like, make it here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Famous words, you only have this, she only has a shot for one. That's possible that that's not true, Vic.
My draws.
If Shannon comes down and does something like that, there'll be a triple for a pile of shots. You have to be able to hide this in here. It's a great call. There's nothing wrong with it, but you're going to have to bury it, or there could be a potential big end here.
What would be wrong of just hitting the stone top edge of the four right on the nose and just sitting there?
The red one, that would be the perfect call, but I don't think they can quite see enough of it. Okay. You might jam it in the process.
All right.
Just a touch more.
Have to really be careful with this one.
Lots of room.
Eight,
nine.
Deep.
You got a lot of weight.
Oh boy.
Nine, ten.
Is it five? Nope.
You can see the front end hasn't put a brush to it. And now.
Curl.
You should have swept it.
If you bang that right on the nose, will they go?
Well, you can't quite hit on the nose, you'll miss the shot rock, but a little high side, I think they will, Vic, especially with these lively stones.
If I just get the hit and roll, it's fine. But okay. With control, how much do I have to tap that back?
A lot, because you're jamming, right? You have to move it out of the forefoot.
So you want to play this, then?
I don't think we could try.
Like, just off nose?
You can see all of the ones.
Would they all go if you just off nose it?
With, like, peel?
Probably. Do you think this one would go, though? Because your shooter might not stay, right?
You still get one.
Yeah.
It's like, you gotta get, like, three quarters. Yeah. Don't try. I say try it.
Do you want it?
Yeah. Peel.
Try to get the triple here.
Okay.
Because you catch this one, you might catch this one on the way by, so just sweep this one.
Okay, because you have about
we'll be
that
one,
much
though,
on
right?
the side.
What'd you say, Sid?
You have about this much.
That's fine.
That's fine.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, I love the call, Vic, and that's what we mentioned earlier. The team Manitoba did not see this coming. This shot is here.
I say hit it thin.
Three quarters of a rock. Okay. You have to, the key thing is hit this shot rock very, very thin. If they hit it too thick, they'll miss this one.
You have to go hard on that one then. I say we try to get this one out more this so than this one.
Yeah,
yeah.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Peel?
Just a hair off center. They're all going to fly. You might lose your shooter. But it's a potential score of three here.
And as they said, even if you miss and do leave the one that's sitting full back eight, they have their shot that is top edge of the four that would be their counter.
Three quarters on that side?
So worth the risk. The reward is possible three.
It's definitely worth the risk. You hit it high side, you score. That's the main thing. A really good chance for a possible three if this is thrown properly.
Final stone, arms go up, weight is up. BC, Corryn Brown, little brush now, got the line, high side. How have they got? There they go for three. And it's interesting, it's not the third point that they thought they would get. They thought they might actually lose the shooter. They kick out their own on the side, but they still get three. BC takes the lead. Big shot by the 17-year-old Corryn Brown to give BC three. And she wanted to play it.
She did, Vic. And how many people see it? How many people at that age would see a triple? The safe shot's to come down there, tap it, try to score your one. But you not only have to see it, you have to hit it exactly right. You have to throw it very hard. The lively rocks help. They just go out like alleys, gets the bonus off the corner. Three big points.
I hate to say it. You're showing your age. I don't think many
alleys.
Children play with alleys. Always wanted the Furies. Remember the Furies?
Yeah, the big ones.
Oh, yeah. Well, the boulders were the biggies, but the clear ones, they were the Furies. 4-2, BC leads. As we go to the eighth, it'll be Manitoba that has the last rock, playing the yellow stones. And now every stone is going to be crucial where it's positioned.
I'd recommend any curling club that is watching this broadcast to have their rocks reconditioned, go to the professionals, talk to the top ice makers that we have, that these are so exciting to play with. We're going to see some wonderful shots at the Brier with these lively stones. That triple was, all three ran out of there in a hurry. What a wonderful shot. I said at the top of the broadcast, Corryn's three players in front of her are ninth, fourth, and fifth, which is good, but it doesn't give her as much support as, for instance, Shannon had. So Corryn's had to make some big shots all week to get to this position, and no bigger than that one.
Get it fighting. Go, go, go.
Of a dangerous call for BC there. They're trying to choke off the corner guard. That makes some sense, but it's another rock that's in play. And like 2-point lead. You don't need a pile of rocks in play. That long yellow corner guard was not a good one. Even if BC has a rock around that one, BC will be able to tap it out.
Yeah, it's all there.
Little chance here for Manitoba.
Yeah. Mine only. Yep.
Mariah drops her head.
How up are we?
Nine. Wool then. No. Never.
9-10.
We're through.
8. Sit down.
And we'll hang on to the back edge of the 12. Just a weight problem?
Yeah, she knew right away, Vec. It's like when you snap one out of bounds when you're golfing, and you know right away.
Sure do.
See?
The player knows right away. And it was a big rotation on those, and that makes them glide a little farther, too. And it was in a really quick spot. So she really didn't throw it that bad. Just got caught in another one of those really, really quick spots.
Yeah, harder! Hard!
Okay, so
I'm going to split on that one,
Yeah.
You that's
wouldn't, wouldn't have curled that much.
Fine. Okay.
Rock, the red British Columbia rock at the back will help here.
Get up. We're like an 8.
Quarter guard. It's one of the best situations Manitoba's had.
Do we get a tick over?
That's okay.
Close. Yep.
Whoa.
Try not to bump the red one out, though. Nice.
I don't mind being a little high.
Yeah.
Have to bring it okay, that's fine then. Yeah, if you're there, it's not bad.
I guess.
Okay, touch less. Touch
less. I'm so impressed with the thought process here from this young team from British Columbia. You don't have to freeze to the back one here because they'll give.
Yes.
Team Manitoba the exact same opportunity. So just go top 8 here if you have to.
Back 8.
Hard then.
Whoa.
Back 4.
What?
Back 4, back 8.
Yeah, freeze it.
Hard, girls. Hard. Okay.
Okay.
Forward.
For the last hand.
Yeah,
you got it right up.
Same thing again. No danger yet for Manitoba.
Right to us. It's really nice.
Good. Where?
7.
Where?
Whoa. 8.
Whoa.
Whoa, then.
Still a little up.
Still 7, 8.
Whoa.
8. Yep.
Where?
8.
Whoa.
Easy.
Yep. Take it right to it.
What's that?
Thank you.
good speed, but a little bit of an overcurl. If BC chooses to, they can tap that yellow pretty easily.
Or do you want to just go straight down to it?
I don't mind to it.
Okay.
On that side. If I'm up, it's not bad though.
Yeah.
Danger with to it is then you're setting up a little bit of a wall here, and the top eight might be a little smarter play.
Where?
To it.
It's all there. It's all there.
Okay, let's tap it then.
Mine's pretty good.
Yep.
Yep.
Yes.
Yes.
Hard, girls.
All the way. Mine's real good. Whoa.
Whoa. Whoa. Sit.
Tap it.
Okay, Erin.
The red one hitting on the inside, that just about eliminates that yellow, but look what happens when this goes in here. It's going to be almost impossible to remove it. Oh, this spot so well, if they could freeze it without bumping it, or even in front of the red ones without bumping it, as long as your shot rock. It's a little lighter.
There's a big scrub here. Watch this guard come into play. Can they get this and wrap this around it? No, they won't. It'll rub off and spin it into the top edge of the eighth. A lot of men's provincial finals settled up today. Brad Gouju is a winner, 10th time. He'll go out of Newfoundland, Labrador. Paul Fleming wins Nova Scotia, 9th time. Brad Jacobs, 4th straight from Northern Ontario. The defending champion Canadian World, Howard, is back. 15th time. Kevin Martin will go for a 12th time. And Jeff Stoughton, he'll go for a 10th time to the Briar in Edmonton. What a great field. Two provinces still to be decided. BC will be decided later today. Heavy snow in PEI has delayed their championship. And they're playing that at the Crapo Curling Club, which is between Summerside and Borden, and that, of course, is the home of Ted McFadgen, the fabulous McFadgen family, and lots of great memories with them and the people at the Crapo Curling Club. They have a
bounce it off. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Roll it.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, roll it.
Yes. Whoa, whoa,
fit.
It's not bad, Erin.
And we can update you on the fourth end of that BC men's final, and Andrew Bolesky with a 3-0 lead over a former champion in Brent Pierce.
Yeah, Brent would have to be the favorite on paper in that game, but obviously it's not played on paper. And that's not over yet, but it's going to be a battle, that one. Boy, it's getting a little bit claustrophobic here for Manitoba.
I like playing a 10 at it.
I don't know how we do this.
I don't mind playing that yellow one.
Yeah, I like that too. I don't mind just tapping it to the...
With like back line or like back
four? I like
moving
stuff. You can play like back eight at it.
We need to score two here.
This way. I like that.
You don't think we can get it this way?
No, it curls so hard.
Where is theirs?
It finishes really hard. What?
Where are they sitting?
They're back four.
Back four?
I think we just do this.
I love the call, but it's the consequences like if they miss that could be disastrous.
Pardon me?
We know the line for that spot.
Yeah.
It's all there. I mean, if you just tap it to here, that's okay.
It just cut so hard, though. Like it's my last one did.
Yeah, but I don't know if we take less. I think it might hang on the center line. I think it curls more coming off the outside, you know?
I think we have to get rid of that back one. Or some red.
So you want to play weight then?
Like if I nose, that's pretty good.
We have a time.
Nose isn't bad. I don't mind getting it out.
Done it.
Because you could go to this right there.
Play like bump?
Yeah, I don't mind bump. Okay. If you just get this, that's okay.
Yeah.
Nicole did not want to play the draw. The draw would be, in the perfect world, that's the perfect shot. But if you don't make it, you're in real trouble. So she's going to try to throw some weight at this. She's more comfortable with it. Run it in this way. But what if it doesn't work? It goes this way. You pump another red in there somewhere. It could be a long end for Manitoba. This is a big shot.
So I was going to ask you, do you sometimes tend to, when they're, and maybe it's just the person, you feel more comfortable with the update weight than playing something softer?
For sure. You know, maybe you've struggled with the, the draw weight. She talked about having a rock that curls more in the first end. Maybe that's why she's playing the shot. It's not wrong.
Andries Mondor would love to just touch this yellow back. Oh, wonderful shot. Great crushing from the front end.
What a message to a young player. If you don't want to play a certain shot, speak up. The skip, Shannon said, okay, if you want to play some weight, I'm with you. You're the most important person at this point. What a beautiful run back. Too many teams are influenced by the skip, saying, well, no, you got to do this. Well, if you don't want to play it, speak up. Great, that was a great shot.
You also then have to make it.
Go out there, good point.
Skip Stones. Corryn Brown.
Really hard! Really hard!
Now it's Fisher and Fraser.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay. Sorry.
Couldn't find it. Look for the hole. Well, we talked earlier about the lack of experience on Corryn Brown's side compared to Birchard, who's last year's runner-up.
Well, you know, Corryn's shots have been a little bit tougher, to be fair. So that 7% bonus plus minus is really impressive. And the triple last end could be the game winner.
The player numbers are brought to you by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
No, I don't either. It'll be piece open, though. Or half open, you know?
Because you got to desk it by that red one.
Yeah.
Okay.
An awkward situation for both teams. When you come down with draw weight here, it's going to curve so much, it might not be closer than that red one at the back of the four. So I think they're going to be just filling this area here.
Like a six, like not onto you.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
If it's a little shorter, that's okay.
Yeah,
let us know though.
I was gonna say probably five better than a seven.
Let us know though, okay?
Okay, fill it to us, four.
You got it, Shani.
Trying to go half buried, but I don't think she'll be second shot if she goes too deep.
Line's good, guys.
Yes,
good. Go a little.
Just left. Hard.
Yes.
Hard.
Where?
Six.
Line's perfect. Hard.
Andries on the left. Mondor on the right.
They're yelling six. I don't think that's a six.
We're just three. We're just three.
And they're going to be all over that corner.
Getting fooled on that inside out out turn, Vic. We talked about it in N2. There were a couple over curls.
Rice. More. Do you like it still? Yeah, I still like it.
Just control?
Control. I'll just throw it better. Touch more.
Okay.
Should have thrown it better, guys.
This is not a big opening here, but just if this shot's made.
Control?
Big trouble for BC. I don't think he can hit it on the broom side, but if you could, they'd sit as many as four or five.
Control.
Here we go, final stone.
Whoa.
For BC.
Right off.
Close.
I'll just throw it better, she said. Nothing yet. Fisher Fraser, nothing yet. Find the hole, come through, got it. Oh, beauty and through. Oh my, what a shot.
They did hit, squeak that guard, hit it thin enough just to move the yellow. Big problems here now. The confidence to sweep it, keep it that close to the red guard. Yeah. Just ticks red onto yellow. Sitting five.
Okay, let's go.
This bang though, this little raise here of that red. She had the yellow catcher.
Exactly. I knew it was there, but I didn't think she'd get that close to the guard. Oh boy.
Make it then.
When we talk about different spots, remember this exact same shot. British Columbia called a timeout. They didn't want to throw the draw here.
Right.
It should be a hair slower here because it hasn't been warmed up recently.
All that experience now of last year, runner-up. She'll need every bit of it now, facing five, and she needs to put a stone half on the button. And it gets very, very quiet. Trailing by two. BC leads 4-2. Manitoba and Shannon. Birchard. Here they go. Andres, Mondor. Uh-oh, facing five. Here comes Sigvaldason, facing five. Gotta get it to the button, facing five. Get it to the button, facing five. Facing five. Oh!
Unbelievable.
What a brilliant shot. We saw two brilliant shots back to back. Facing five, game is on the line. You gotta drag it to the button. What a game. It's time now for the M&M Meat Shop's Final End Challenge. Right after the game, go to FinalEnd.ca and enter the secret word for a chance to win a trip for two to the 2014 World Junior Curling Championship in Flims, Switzerland. The first 100 entries will have a chance to win a $50 M&M gift card, and all participants will get an M&M discount. Go to FinalEnd.ca after the game, but not before we give you the secret word. That could be fantastic. The word could be fantastic. We have seen two fantastic shots back to back, first by BC and Corryn Brown to come through the hole, and then what a wonderful draw facing five, Shannon Birchard.
Well, you know, first of all, you don't expect to face five. It looked like they're in good shape. You weren't even sure Corryn would get through the opening. If she doesn't, it's a free draw for two with very little risk. She makes it so good, all of a sudden you're looking at five, and to get shot rock was nearly impossible. You had to scare the guard. You reckon the guard, the game's over, and incredible job by the whole team in that shot. Well brushed all the way down.
Do you guys want another guard?
No. I mind coming in.
I want to come in.
Okay.
Come in.
Okay. That's fine.
You got it.
So with the single in eight, it's a 4-3 BC lead, and it is the team from Kamloops.
22.
The BC champions, skipped by Corryn Brown, will have the last rock. They have the hammer. Here in the ninth, playing the Redstones.
Six. No.
A lot of the teams will throw two guards in this situation. They're one down without. They have to force the situation. They do not want BC to blank this end.
Still back.
I thought they might throw the second one short.
God, at least shot. Down the barrier.
Stop.
Be wide open here
and deep.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what? She knows it. You know, I mean, her front end is conveying, saying, hey, it's seven, it's eight. She's going, no. But out of her hand.
Just hack. Little up.
Sydney Fraser throwing the lead stones.
Just hack. It's not that much. Backline hack.
Don't touch it.
Whoa.
This is a spin here. It's lucky it's soft weight. It should finish enough to hit it.
Hard outer. Go right out.
No.
Okay, sit.
Okay.
Ten?
Yeah.
Let's go. Show me my mitt.
Shayna Andrews.
Line's a little wide.
Six,
little
wide. Seven.
Whoa,
eight.
Nine.
No.
Whoa.
Nine.
Oh, boy. Nine's not the right number, and it's certainly not going to be buried. It can, you can see it's wider path than last time. Needs to stop.
That other one.
And brushers marching beside a stone is never a good sign. It'll slip for a third shot. You know, it's that time of the game, too.
Gotta get
you gotta control the emotions, the adrenaline that goes with it.
Really unfortunate part for that last one was it's going to be a double eventually at the back.
Well, the three podium finishers from last year in Red Deer are all back for this year's Scotties in Kingston. They include Manitoba's Jennifer Jones, the bronze medal winner from 2012. And with her eighth Scotties appearance, BC's Kelly Scott will be in Kingston, runner-up. And Heather Nedewin, last year won the hard way. She won the 3-4 game semifinal, then the final. The defending Scotties champions, they will be Team Canada in Kingston at the Scotties Tournament of Hearts. It all begins next Saturday. Our coverage begins at 2 p.m. Eastern Time. You can see it on TSN and, of course, TSN Mobile TV. The Scotties Tournament of Hearts from Kingston. And this will be our first matchup. Heather Nedewin against Andrea Crawford. Andrea Kelly, of course.
That's right.
Previous years.
Another returnee has been there a lot, and Andrea was unbelievable in the provincials. Really didn't have a close game the whole week, so I think she's got the best team she's had ever.
BC with the last rock. Everything's back to the tee line.
Two yellow Manitoba rocks in there is the good news, but it's really only one yellow rock because the double's so easy. They have to be very careful not to miss any more shots here. They have to get this in the right spot.
Three,
so easy to slide
three,
into the rings on these, and then it's a chance to score a potential two for BC if this slides in the ring.
Sit down.
It's
really finishing hard here.
Yeah.
Nicole Sigvaldason is 20 years of age, as are Shayna Andrews and Mariah Mondor. So this will be their last year of junior play, and Shannon Birchard, the skip for Manitoba, is just 18 years of age. So she'll have 2 years left, so she'll have to rebuild a team if she's to continue on in junior play. Whereas the BC team, as we've mentioned, the youngest here, all of them 17 years of age.
They could hit and roll in here. Yeah, it would really change the dynamics of this end.
Hard! Whoa! 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 No roll. Sit.
Oh, nice shot.
Okay.
We freeze to this one.
I don't mind that freeze.
You freeze.
Do you like that freeze?
Yeah, I like.
You guys
the
like that?
Yeah.
Okay, let's make it here.
You're staying in the rings, it makes it difficult.
Is
it Manitoba, for instance, decides to hit that top one, rolls out. There's a yellow double, and at best, Manitoba's going to end up forcing BC to probably blank the end, and that's exactly what BC wants. So. Same thing
eight,
here,
nine,
you play the
ten.
Freeze, you cannot
we're
miss
through.
This heavy. Yikes. Needs to finish hard.
Gotta stick around on these guys. Okay.
and will stick around, but goes deep back edge.
It's easy from up here, Vic, but anywhere up in this area would have worked. And especially because of this situation. That's a pretty simple double. They can either hit it dead on and sit two, or they can peel them away and sit two.
Pin caught.
It's fine if you just roll out, Aaron. It's not a big deal.
Because we are.
Atta girl. Watch it. Atta girl.
And gets the one in the back as well. So BC clears everything out. Sits two. They do have last rock. They have the lead here in the ninth.
Don't you love these running bands? One, two, three with hack weight, triple, and rollout. The rollout's not a problem because now British Columbia with advantage of hammers sitting two. It's going to get more and more difficult to force them to a single.
Let's go here.
Yeah, let's go.
I just really want just to come up at all these. Maybe a little less ice.
For you, I think probably about a 9.5.
Okay.
The length. Yours are coming down right
down on the corner?
Yeah, got to glue it.
Andrews, Mondor, pick her up. Trying to get her team out of some trouble here. Wants to take this right down. Got to get it by this guard first, though. Got to get it by that one first. Take it down, bump it back. Oh, and have a look now. It may be, it looks like it is. Shot stone.
Very nice.
Boy, they held it just enough, Russ.
Yeah, it's, would have loved to have it on top of it, but it is shot and it's partly buried. Coast to coast brushing again, and just spectacular weight control one more time from Shannon. Just a little overcurl.
I said you have to hit it. Okay, because they're shot, right?
Yeah, or so control even, because you want to probably stick
control,
your shooter.
Control,
okay.
Let's right. Do this, because this one should pop out the back. So.
Okay, it's straight pick.
Perfect world, you'd like to tap it and hang around, but you just can't see much of it. And just make it move, any type of weight, pick it clean, but we're almost right behind it. You cannot see a lot of that yellow one with that front red one. It's a difficult shot. I'd say a small half, Vic. And this really curls hard at the end.
Normal,
normal.
Whoa, close. No.
Corryn Brown, her first.
Just sweep through yellow, Aaron. Go, Aaron, go.
And we'll move it back, and it looks like it is shot stone.
That's huge.
Manitoba is sitting shot.
Just a foot lighter, she makes that.
Yeah.
Took the paint off the side of it, but didn't move it far enough. Nicely thrown, but just any lighter, it curls that silly half an inch more. Yellow's definitely shot there. Split the house here and get that force that they've been trying for the whole end.
How does it hit that little of it?
Yeah, it doesn't come out much.
Yeah, let's go.
Could be a double here. They want to keep it high as they can.
Okay.
Nicely done.
Interestingly enough, it was Nicole managing the house that said, yes. Okay, you can lay off now. Let's leave it high.
Yeah, because the original call, Vic, was here. If they put it here, there is no double. But the great judgment and the communication said it's light, so they stopped it, because if they keep brushing and put it here, there would have been a half rock natural double. Well done.
final stone.
Whoa. It's in double?
No. In double?
It's coming. It's coming.
Ferns are going to roll.
Sit. It's fine.
One.
Okay.
And over.
Good. One.
It did come up for them. One it is. One for BC here in nine. The women's final, the M&M Meat Chops Canadian Juniors will come down to the 10th. Well, it's time now for the M&M Meat Chops final and challenge. And the secret word is hard. Right after the game, go to finalend.ca and enter that secret word, hard, for a chance to win a trip for two to the 2014 World Junior Curling Championships in Flims, Switzerland. Hard is your secret word, the final end challenge. So a week of great curling here in Fort McMurray comes down to this, the 10th and final end on a Sunday. The women's final, BC leads 5-3. Manitoba does have the last rock playing the Yellowstones.
If this is the future for men's and ladies curling, we're in pretty good shape, Vic. A lot of great shots. Corryn just took the paper off the side of that rock and would have had a potential big score this end, but a nice freeze by British Columbia or by Manitoba, and a nice hit and stay by BC to get the force of the single. But all the same, they're now two up.
No line.
Five.
Clear.
No.
Four.
Looks like it's coming
Three.
Down. Okay.
Yeah, it's coming down.
Clean it.
Okay.
No. No.
Clean.
No. 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 No.
It. It's okay.
Okay. Good.
Good.
Perfect corner over, nice and wide. Lots of curl on that intern side.
406. Okay. Same way.
You know, both teams struggle with draw weight for a little while for the first three, maybe four ends. After that, it's been really putting it on the X. Exceptional curling.
Same. To it.
A little less.
To it. Line's
room,
line's
guys.
Good.
A little bit of room.
To it.
Whoa,
little bit of room.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Okay, over there.
Whoa, whoa.
Whoa.
Just
no, no,
just
no.
Do it.
Let it curl. No bomb. Yep, you're good. You're coming down. Yep, going out. Yep.
Okay, yep.
Yep, freeze it right on. Lock
go,
it on.
Go, go, go.
Lock it, lock it, lock it, lock it, lock it. Hard. Hard.
That's okay. Good.
Well, they got everything out of that storm, boy.
Down. Down.
Down.
Roll these like you can.
Let's go.
Got it. Same weight.
Three perfect stones so far in the biggest end of their lives. Mm-hmm. You want to keep some separation, obviously,
line's
here. That's
good.
The easy part with the big curl, but you want to have them virtually the same distance so there isn't a double peel
three.
Opportunity.
Goal, Shayna. Hard, Shayna.
Hard,
you got it.
Hard!
Hard,
go, 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 you got it. Go!
Hard!
You really go to match them up.
Even, go, go, go!
Hard! Hard.
Big scrub, Andries, Sigvaldason, trying to even them up. And they have come pretty close.
Very nice.
Got it. Yep.
Sam Fisher.
Clean.
Whoa.
Just
Whoa.
Clean.
No.
It's good.
Clean.
It's
yeah.
Good.
Go sit. Yeah. Nice throw.
Teams approach this a little differently, Vic. I watched the Stoughton game today, and he didn't put two red ones in. He had the advantage of a two-point lead. He only put one in. Sometimes those can come back to hurt you. But the position of both those reds are beautiful. Remember the years ago with the Furby team and Mark Dacey, they didn't quite get them in the right spots. They
two,
were
three.
Staggered, and it cost a three-ender for...
Two, three.
Alberta to lose the Briar final that year.
Pull if you can.
Oh.
Gotta move. Pull first if you can.
Switch.
Yep.
Even if you can.
Hard.
Ooh. Hard neck. Even.
Hard, you got it.
Got it.
well thrown stone.
Nice throw, Steph.
That's not the way you'd see out of some of the top men's teams, but you don't need it on this ice. Just hit it in the right spot, half a rock. It allows the thrown rock to spin, and it'll roll forever.
Shayna Andrews.
Wait to see him.
I think it's time to move.
Even line's better.
Even.
Just even if you can.
We gotta go, babe.
Yep.
We gotta go.
Yep. Right here, guys. Right here. Hard.
Sure, it's bro. Right,
yeah. Hard.
Go. A little more.
Well, it started off very slowly with just 1 point through the first five, but man, it's been terrific since then.
Wow, Corryn Brown's triple in the seventh. That was one of the best I've seen in a long, long time. That's what set up the lead, but probably outdone by the beautiful draw by Shannon against five in the eighth. Not only against five, but around a center guard to the pin to keep this game going.
The game story brought to you by M&M Meat Shops, frozen food at its best.
Perfect curling end, Vic. Top of the four in the center line. Corner guard in the right spot. Top eight lined up. Perfect corners, equidistant. And then three nice peels by British Columbia here. Just a great end.
Nine.
Now it's time to go around the one they threw the first time. And they threw that one on the intern side because there's a bit more curl in the intern side. You know you're going to have to play a come around. You want to play on the swing side.
Nicole Sigvaldason
had
a little difficulty in the game with her draw weight.
Yes.
Hard. Got to be here. Hard.
It's not heavy.
Hard. Go hard.
So Andrews
hard,
Mondor
bounce
picked
bounce
her
bounce
up.
Hard.
She'll be all over it.
A little fortunate, Vic. It's light and the double's there, but if you hit it in the middle to make the yellow double, where does that yellow one that was just thrown go?
Okay, just the one.
So you just have to go for the single. It's too dangerous to run an enemy rock into the rings.
Aaron Pincott.
As we talked about earlier, the mistake was made the right way. If you throw in the around the corner guard through the rings, it's your last opportunity to possibly score two. So at least it was light. So just a hair more weight here and they can get it around that corner.
So eight, nine would be back.
Yes.
Back eight, back 12. Got to get a high first.
I mean, look at this. It just took off on them.
Where? 9, 8. Bury it right back.
Oh, well done.
And they'll take it buried just back of the T line, edge of the eight. Oh, little panic, but it seemed to move on them very quickly here.
Yeah, it did, and it must have slowed down a bit because it was ended up being a seven, so the 8-9 came down a couple feet. Beautiful stone. Two options here, and this is what I love about the sport. There's always options. It's very, very rarely is there just one single option. You could come down here, just simply peel the guard, roll away. Yes, that would give Manitoba the chance to score their 2 points, but they have to deal with this double here. They'd have to make that perfectly and hang around. This is the right call if it's made. You
guess we could just guard ours.
Yeah, I think Ken might be giving them the other option of peeling that corner.
So the second time out, 92nd. Timeout has been called by BC, and that will bring Ken Brown to the ice.
Yeah.
That's buried, eh?
Oh, yeah. That was a pistol.
That's a good shot.
Even the BC team acknowledging that. Terrific draw by Sigvaldason.
Corryn, we can guard it. Okay, if we peel the guard, she has to make a play on that one. If she makes the double, she's got to make the double. She might leave you. She's got to make the double and go this way. That would set you up for a double to make on your next one. You know what I'm saying? If you peel the guard, she has to make a play on that. That gives you a shot at a double for the win, or wide open, you go the extra end. Or you can guard it if you like the guard. But I would go for the peel. Okay. And then she has to make a play this way, okay?
Okay. All right, explain, Coach Brown.
Let's go.
Well, I love what he's saying there. The peel, that's what I was trying to say before they called the timeout. The peel makes the most sense because it almost guarantees an extra end, Vic. Yes, they can come down and make Manitoba maybe make the double, but where's that yellow one going to roll? If it happens to roll over here, there could be a double to potentially win the game because the guard's gone. The only way you give up three is to play the come around, which was the original call.
No. Clean.
No.
You're got it.
Clean. Skip stones.
Shot.
And got it. And away it goes. Now we'll see how it plays out.
Third option was thrown out there, and that's one of those you'll argue about after the game's over, too, is you could have guarded it. You hate to with a two-point lead, but that would have put a lot of pressure on Manitoba also.
I think I like 9-5 because I want to make sure we get rid of one.
Well, you're gonna
I know, but like...
Just on the nose.
Yeah. I like 9-5. I don't really know what 10 does in this spot. Okay.
Is it a situation, Russ, where you would, because it's all about the double, I know, but is there a situation here where you could hit those and not remove them, just push them back?
Yeah, you could. Yeah, I think because you have to score two, you certainly want to get one of them out of the 8 foot, because if you leave them both in the 4 foot, you might see BC just sit three, and then you're going to have to play some type of Hail Mary to, the easiest way to get their deuce here is to make this double.
Okay.
But the key here is you know, with these slippery rocks, you cannot roll out here.
Shannon Birchard, this is her first. Has she got the double? No.
Now, again, another great timeout by Ken Brown. It worked last time. If BC can hit this dead on, they'll be laying two.
Control or normal?
Let's play control, actually. Touch more.
Okay, let's go.
Disgusting. Normal or control?
Huge shot, depending on where they roll here, Vic. Hit it dead on. I think that the only way Manitoba and Shannon Birchard can score two is to play the raised double if this hits and stays roughly where the broom is. Surprised they swept that as far as they did.
Yep. Clean.
Whoa. Final stone for BC. Corryn Brown.
No.
Brushers called right off. Now the question is, will it stay? And it does. But it's rolled now to the back eight, and is there the double there for the deuce?
Oh, no question about it. It's there, Vic. Just rolled a little too far.
Yeah, 9-5.
And she had a very similar shot, an eerily similar shot to the shot against Ontario for four this morning. It was a dangerous call. It was almost the same distance, a high three quarters of a rock run back for four. She made it look easy, so almost dead on makes this, Vic. Can also make it high side, but you'd probably lose your shooter. Just dead on. There it is right there. A great shot of it.
Needs to make them both go away. Hold the shooter, score two, force the extra. Final stone here in 10. Down by a couple. Shannon Birchard back and forth. Body English trying to make this. Will it come up? Now run it back. Stuffed it. She stuffed it. Stuffed it. And it'll hang around at the edge. and back of the eight. BC will pick up one more. BC will pick up the Canadian Junior Women's Championship. Sochi, Russia, beginning February the 28th.
Right on, you guys. I'm so proud of you guys. Come on, I'm proud of you guys.
BC wins the Canadian Women's Junior Championship. Corryn Brown, congratulations. I know lots of tears. How does it feel?
It's indescribable right now. It still hasn't really sunk in, but I could not be more proud of those girls over there. They played amazing that last end, made every shot perfectly. I cannot ask for a better team from them.
Russ said the key would be the first team to adjust to the ice. It seemed to be very quick, was tough to put stones in position. You adjusted. Tell me about the three you got in seven.
We just happened to be set up for a triple there, so I thought we might as well try it. Worst I can give up is one, so we thought we might as well go for it. Kind of the risks outweighed, the benefits outweighed the risks. So we thought we'd go for it and end up making it good. So that three win was a big deal.
It is remarkable how far junior curling, I think, has come in our country. The fact that you're 17, your whole team is 17 and playing at this level.
Yeah, it's incredible. It's kind of nice knowing that we can compete with these older girls and we don't have to be the same age and we can gain the same experience within less years.
Congratulations. You can
thank
go cry some more and
so
enjoy your time in
thank
Russia.
Thank you so much.
Wonderful experience for them to pick up the win. And now they will be off to Russia to represent Team Canada.
Team BC!
And here they are, Canada. The 2013 Canadian Junior Women's Champions from the Kamloops Curling Club in British Columbia. All of them 17 years of age. Corryn Brown, Aaron Pincott, Sam Fisher, Sydney Fraser, and their coach, Ken Brown. And I tell you, they took two timeouts, and Coach Brown had wonderful thoughts, wonderful ideas each time.
Did he ever? The first time was nobody was making any draws. They wanted to draw. She ended up playing the hit against three, made it. And the second time, it was also brilliant. A low-risk 10th end that worked out perfectly.
Mr. Dave Newton, M&M Meat Shop's local franchisee, will present bronze medals from Ontario, while Hugh Avery, Vice Chair of the Canadian Curling Association Board of Governors, presents Keeper Awards. Team Ontario, Coach Graham Sinclair. Lead, Aaron Jenkins. Second, Caitlin Wasilki. Third, Holly Donaldson. And skip, Jamie Sinclair.
The Ontario champions from the Manitic Curling Center, just south of Ottawa, Sinclair. Her final year
Mr.
of
Newton will now present
junior curling. She went 7-5 a year ago
Manitoba.
In Napanee.
Oh, Jody Mercier. Host committee co-chair will present Keeper Awards. Team Manitoba coach, Bruce Birchard. Lead, Mariah Mondor. Second, Shayna Andries. Third, Nicole Sigvaldason. And skip, Shannon Birchard.
An obvious disappointment, Russ, for this team. Shannon, a runner-up a year ago, and a runner-up again out of the St. Vital Curling Club in Winnipeg.
The champions from the province of British Columbia. Well, Cindy Maddox. CCA Board Liaison to the M&M Michelle Juniors presents Keeper Awards. Team British Columbia, coached by Ken Brown. Lead Sydney Fraser. Second, Sam Fisher. Third, Aaron Pincott. And skip, Corryn Brown.
Congratulations to the BC champions out of the Kamloops Curling Club, as they will now go on to represent Canada at the World Juniors in Sochi, Russia, beginning February the 28th. And they, along with Manitoba's champions from the West Kildonan Curling Club in Winnipeg, Matt Dunstone, Colton Lott, Dan Grant, and Brendan McCush, they will be the two Canadian teams to represent our country at the World Juniors, and we wish them both the very, very best. And just a reminder, we'll move on now as our season of champions continues. We'll go on to Kingston, Ontario. And it all begins next Saturday at 2 p.m. Eastern Time. Draw one of the Scotties, the defending champions, Team Canada. Heather Nedewin will go against New Brunswick and Andrea Crawford as we begin our coverage of the Scotties. Thank you, Fort McMurray, for being such a wonderful host the entire week. We look forward to a return one day to the oil patch. Thanks to our crew for their hard work this weekend. We thank you for joining us. And now on behalf of Russ and our entire crew, till we talk with you again next week in Kingston, thank you for joining us here. Canada's most comprehensive curling coverage is on Canada's Sports Leader, TSN.